Hello guys, hopefully everyone is fine. In this video we will be discussing the concept of static data members and static member functions. Now in the previous video we discussed how classes are created. Now normally we are creating integer variables using data members and accessing them using member functions. There are some additional things which are supported in class. Firstly, static data members. Guys, this is a data member which is shared by maximum objects. So what for all the objects it will attain the same memory, because it will hold the same memory, it is shared by different objects. And static member functions, there is a different way of accessing static member functions without using the concept of objects. So that is also one of the important factors that I wanted to discuss. Kindly watch the video till the very end and support us. So we'll start with static data members and static member functions. So what we have to do is that firstly we have to understand the property of static data members. First property, all objects share static data members. Firstly, it has to be initialized outside the class. By default, its value is 0. So this is these are the main important things, and it can be accessed by normal member functions and static member functions. That's what are the properties of static data members. Firstly, they hold the same memory for different objects. If I have 5 objects, all 5 objects will share the same memory for that data member. It has to be initialized outside the class. The moment you declare it, class ends, you have to declare outside. So there is a syntax for it. Then there by default, it will hold the value of 0. I won't give any value. By default, its value will be 0. And it can be accessed by all the member functions or even static member functions. I'll talk about static member functions later. So we'll start. We just create a class like we did in the last video. Class A. I'm just using a word static int C, and let's say int A. So there are two data members that I have used. This is a static data member and this is normal data member. So the normal, I'm declaring it public. I'm using, let's say again, void details. And I can, guys, listen, this is a very important factor of it. I can give the value of C over here as 5 and A over here as 7, and I can display them. It's again up to me. It's entirely up to me that what kind of value that I have to basically use. Or I can take the value of C and I can take the value of A as well. This is how it is. There is another function that I'm going to create, that is static void take. So guys, this is static member function. The property with static member function is it can access only static data member. It means it can only access this. It cannot access this int A. So I can write C is equal to, or I can take the value of C in from this and C out accordingly. So I'm closing the class. So guys, the moment class is closed, what I have to do is I have to initialize this. Int C I have written, but I have to initialize this. How it can be initialized? The initialization can be done using a particular syntax as data type, class name, space class name, scope resolution, or static data member, semicolon. So it means data type of this static int C is int, class name is capital A, scope resolution and member function is C. You just write it as such. By default, C will get a zero value. Main, I'm writing main over here. I'm creating 3 objects. Let's say obj 1, 2 and 3. Guys, let me tell you that all objects will share this C. सो फॉर ऑब्जेक्ट वन इफ वैल्यू इज 5, फॉर ऑब्जेक्ट टू वैल्यू और ऑब्जेक्ट थ्री ऑब्जेक्ट सी वट एवर इज इनिशियलाइज लास्ट ऑल वैल्यूज फॉर ऑब्जेक्ट वन टू एंड थ्री विल बी ऑब्टेन्ड फॉर सी. लेट्स से इफ आई एम क्रिएटिंग एनी काइंड ऑफ फंक्शन एंड इनिशियलाइज सी एज 5, सी एज 7, सी एज 9. सो वेर एवर इज लास्ट इनिशियलाइजेशन 9, 9 वैल्यू विल बी शेयर्ड बाय ऑब्जेक्ट 1, 2 एंड 3. सो वट विल डू इज आई जस्ट आई एम राइटिंग obj1 dot let's say details. I can take that. So what it will do is it will take the value of c and it will take the value of a and it will display both the values, or there are many ways of doing so. I can access the value using this take, but for accessing data for accessing member functions, you know, object is not even required. So for accessing member functions, what we can do is we can just use class name. Class name is a scope resolution take. By default, it will access the value of c, and that value of c will be shared by object 1, 2, and 3. So that's the beauty of this. You don't need to have an object name for accessing static member functions. Only class name is sufficient. But this is very, very important. It has to be done. And a scope resolution take is there for sharing the memories. That setting data members can be used, but it's again up to the programmer or up to the situation what we are having. Details is accessed by object 1. Why? Because it is a normal member function. And for static member function, it's simply class name scope resolution take. By default, it should work. If you like this video, kindly like, share and subscribe, and kindly share it to maximum audience so that we can reach numbers. Thank you very, very much for the support.